This is TWiT.
You may remember Epic Games, well, speaking of Spotify, Spotify Tile and others formed the Coalition for App Fairness. They wrote bill which they sent to the North Dakota State Senate that would force Apple to allow iPhone owners to sideload apps and to use alternative in-app payment options. In other words, not to use the App Store. Just now, according to this tweet, the North Dakota Senate voted the bill down. So that was averted. Disaster for Apple was averted. But Arizona and Georgia are considering similar bills, and I imagine Epic is not going to rest until they get some state to say, no, you can't have an App Store, Apple.
Yeah, and then it'll go to the Supreme Court. Then it'll be dead. Yeah. Like it's not constitutional. It's not gonna go anywhere. And the problem is that Epic is fighting this stupid battle because they are clearly the technology leaders in real time 3D. And I would be surprised if in March or June or whenever Apple does another keynote, if Apple doesn't take the spot that they were giving to Unreal, the millions of dollars of hundreds of millions of dollars of PR that they were giving them, and say, hey, let's see what Unity's doing. You know, and let's see how this, we'll see, but I would be surprised. Apple's never going to show Epic again on a keynote ever, you know? And so the thing is that the only other option is Unity. And so the thing is for all of us, we're kind of like, you know, people who are developing for the app platform, all of us just kind of step back. like we're like, I'm going to pause for a second. And you know, Epic is doing incredible things. And it's the best thing that Epic's lawsuit is the best thing that happened to Unity in the history of its company. You know, and so it's just...
Because people are using Unity.
Well, Apple's... I will be surprised. We'll see what happens. I will be surprised if Apple ever talks about Unreal again and if it doesn't start pushing Unity down the pipe.
Right.
You know?
I think it's not so much that they're fighting stupidly, it's a stupid fight, but they're fighting stupidly and they're doing it in a way that makes it look like they have... They care about nothing but... being Epic. Like they like to, it's almost like Facebook's small businesses thing where they have clear motivations in order to be like, they want to become an app store and they want to be able to collect rent from a variety of apps, which is what they're doing on the PC using tactics like exclusives, which, you know, some people find objectionable. My whole thing with this is like, my personal preference would be for the iPhone to simply get Gatekeeper the way the Mac has. And that way, like for my mom, my sister, anybody who doesn't care, they would have the exact same safe, trusted app store experience, you know, scam apps aside. And I'm sure we'll get to those eventually, that they've always had. Like, it doesn't take an option away from them. But that the rest of us can, if we really want to, just go in, turn on different Gatekeeper modes, and then sideload things like we do on the app today, on the Mac today. The thing I worry about is that for a lot of mainstream users, traditional computers have been alienating and intimidating and have caused them a lot of pain. And Steve Jobs' express purpose in creating the iPhone and the iPad was to make something more mainstream friendly, something that was a controlled console environment. And we have the Mac, we have Android, we have PCs, but increasingly, even in terms of the complexity of the iPad and iPad OS, it feels like us 10-20% of traditional computer users are like, no, those are pretty. We want those too. And we don't care that in many ways it's making them worse for mainstream customers. They're pretty and everything should be for nerds. And I really hope we don't lose the vast majority of far less vocal mainstream customers just from our desire to nerdify everything.
The thing that's...
If I want to sideload, I'll use an Android. I have Android phones that I sideload.
Yeah.
It's kind of like I can have whatever I want to geek out on. I just don't do it on my
If you want to get further upset, the North Dakota senator who proposed the bill said he'd been given the draft legislation by a lobbyist for Odney Public Affairs in Bismarck, North Dakota, who said she had been hired by Epic Games and was also being paid by the Coalition for App Fairness. That's the Epic Spotify coalition. And basically, Epic wrote the bill.